You know, around here he's known as the most frequent guest ever on the Morning Point. It's true, because he is. Nevada Coin Mart, Neil Sackmary, the Valley's pro when it comes to buying Yadras and Crystal.
Neil Sackmary of Nevada Coin Mart. Yes. He's back for the third day in a row.
It's fantastic. I tell you that I would love to be here every day. If they would allow me the opportunity, I would be here and just hang out and this and that.
This is three. I mean, no one's got you yet.
Right. Mm-hmm. And so let me tell you, it's the most wonderful place, my store, as well as here at Channel 13.
Thank you.
But it is. I love being here.
A Yadra exclusive, a Crystal exclusive segment on our show.
Right.
Yeah.
So the thing is that, you know, yesterday when we were on here with the BBB, we talked about different types of graded gold coins and things of this nature, right? And on Monday, we talked about the costume jewelry and the gold jewelry and stuff like that, the Rolex watches. And so what people don't know is that we buy name brand collectibles. And so this is, again, the type of item that somebody might have in their house and has value. This is a Hummel. Now, what we find is that when it comes to glassware, Yadros, Hummels, Swarovski crystals, Lalique, Baccarat crystal, things like this. When you buy them, you pay a lot of money, and when you sell them, the value is not there as much. And the problem with that is that most of these type of items, the people that enjoyed them are not on the planet anymore. And so the children or the grandchildren of today, you know, they'd much rather have a digital picture than something they have to dust. And so what happens is that these type of items retain a value. But again, when it comes to what someone paid, it's a far cry from what someone paid to what they sell for. But again, you know, the value of something is based on what someone will pay, not what somebody asks.
And to be able to bring it into Nevada Coin Mart versus just selling it inside, you know, like, hey, I'm going to have a yard sale. Come on, I'll sell it to you for $5. It could be worth a lot more than that.
Absolutely. Right. You know, this is a Yadro right here, the elephant. And so you can see, like, this is signed by Yadro right here. And so this, as a particular item, could be in someone's house. You know, we buy a lot of people that buy from storage units and things like that. And so they're not the original owner. And so the original owner maybe has passed on or something like this. And so what happens is that when we buy things like this, you know, we pay the most money that we can, but you don't want to sell something like this for a dollar or two.
Of course.
This could have substantially more value. And this, and so that's what happens with
some are more valuable than
absolutely.
My eye is always drawn to the crystal. I love glass.
Yeah.
How do you tell what's worth a lot of money as a crystal? Because there's a lot of crystal at yard sales.
100%. And there's a lot of big box stores that sell like 24% lead crystal glasses and vases and things like this that, you know, are a couple dollars. So when it comes to name brands, you know, Waterford, Lalique, Baccarat, you know, there's something of more substantial names as well as the quality of the crystal. And then on the second part of that is, you know, like I brought in the you know, the Pillsbury.
I've been eyeing this one.
So here's the thing. When it comes to a collectible, again, it comes back to what something can resale for. There's certain people that want to buy the Yadros because they had them, or they want to give them to, you know, their parents or their grandparents or something like this. And then there's collectibles that are just cool. And so I tell people when I buy, if you have something that's unique that you know that nobody has,
like this guy,
that makes it cool, and that's something that we want to buy. And
hey,
so,
hey Sean,
yes,
touch the belly of the guy.
See, the Pillsbury Doughboy and I, we have the same BMI.
You should really have this in your kitchen.
Probably should, I'll tell you. But this is, I mean, this is an example. Sometimes it's not about necessarily what it's made of, but the fact that it has collector value, just like this.
So at the end of the day, this, if it's not the Pillsbury Doughboy, it's worth a dollar or two, right? It's just some random thing. But to be able to, you know, somebody to have. And then again, what we find with the collectibles is that a lot of people like to have what they once had in their childhood.
Of course.
Yes.
Not to even
it's
put
nostalgia.
Something in, but not the nostalgia, right. And so for that, you know what I mean? Like, oh, I'd like to pick that up or something like that.
Yeah.
And it's more easily resaleable sometimes mm-hmm. even than the higher end stuff. Because you're able to get something for yourself and things like that.
Value is relative sometimes.
It certainly
yes,
is.
I agree 100%.
Long story short, if you get stuff, you don't know the value, bring it into you.
Yeah, 100%. You know, any type of the jewelry or anything like that. But again, when it comes to the collectibles, you know, we want to look for this stuff. We want to buy name brand stuff. And we always want to give the very best price.
Neil, love you.
Yeah, thanks.
Hey, you're welcome.
3 days in a row.
Oh,
wow. It's a lot of Neil. Do you know how much your collectible is worth? Neil does. Visit him at Jones and Flamingo. That's his website as well, jonesandflamingo.com. Visit the website or call the number right there on your screen, Nevada Coin Mart, proud sponsor of the Morning Blend. And-